Welcome back, everybody. Chad, we're going to take it to the limit.
We have to. Otherwise, what the hell are we even doing?
Exactly. This is the limit, of course, being a Roadhouse bar known for hot women and a very rough crowd.
Does that mean we're going to walk along the razor's edge?
Yeah. And look who... Skull? I thought that was Danny Trejo for a second.
So did I. No, wait, but he is in the game, though, right?
He is.
Yeah.
Or we could fight Cruz also.
All 4 feet and 6 inches of him?
Yeah. You know
still,
what?
Still blows my mind.
I know. It is very strange. I'm going to fight Skull.
Yeah, it sounds like the safe bet right there. He doesn't sound threatening.
No. Look at that guy. Stupid hair.
He's got a bit of a Native American air to him.
He does.
I think it's the braids.
Yeah, you know what? That might be it. All right. Time to fight Skull. So am I not going to get more of the fun story mode? Stack up to me.
You gonna bleed tonight, Holmes. I don't know. I'm sure they'll pepper it in.
You know what I gotta find? I thought of this last time and I just remembered it. Whoa. Eminem had 2 games. If you remember. I think it was Eminem, or maybe... No, wait, I'm thinking of the first 50 Cent game that I think Eminem is one of the actors in. He plays like a detective. Okay, Skull's a little difficult.
Holy shit.
So, I'm not going to fight him again. Can somebody call for a stretcher? maybe I should go get,
the hell?
What's it doing? Maybe I should go get trained some more.
So I'm looking up what game, like, Eminem in a game.
Yes.
To see, like, what it was. But there's an article that just says... It's from the website thethings.com.
Okay.
20 video games Eminem sucks at. Parentheses. Probably. Parentheses.
What?
I just made an article where they're just like, yeah, I bet this guy sucks at this game. You know what else he probably sucks at? Donkey Kong.
Is that one of them?
Number 20 is Ms. Pac-Man.
Back for more, huh?
Okay.
Back in September 2018, Eminem treated his Instagram followers to a live video of him playing Ms. Pac-Man. According to Kotaku, not only does Eminem go head-to-head with fellow rapper 50 Cent in Pac-Man, but the latter claimed he cheats at it. With Eminem peeking back at one point during the Instagram live clip, perhaps the rapper isn't as good as he leads on.
Man, this is some real heavy accusations.
Oh, I want to see what number one is. Number 18 is Donkey Kong. What is number one?
Why would Eminem suck at these games? Like, okay. Whatever. I ain't gonna question it. But I am gonna try to fight somebody.
Hold on, number one is FIFA 18. Like many rappers, Eminem has a love of sports. According to the Daily Texan, he loves to represent the Detroit Pistons. While he might try his hand at NBA 2K or even go old school with NBA Jam, it doesn't seem like FIFA 18 interests him, or that he'd even be able to hold his own playing it. Sources, hot new hip hop, Kotaku. They've got sources listed.
Okay.
For telling us that they think he probably wouldn't be good at FIFA.
So they double checked this.
I have to assume they've at least triple checked.
I mean, at least you gotta check your sources. I mean, that's just good journalism.
League of Legends! Number two, League of Legends doesn't seem like Eminem's cup of tea.
No?
Why?
Why?
Why is this an article? With its origins rooted in... Oh, okay. All right. Hold on. There is a little bit of context to that, so...
Okay. Do explain quickly, please, because I am confused.
When explaining in an interview with Complex Magazine the types of video games he prefers playing, the artist said, I want to run and jump. That's it.
Yeah, I guess League of Legends is the first game that comes to mind when I think of doing things that aren't running and jumping.
It says, with its origins rooted in Blizzard's real-time strategy Warcraft 3, it's likely the rapper doesn't care for games that require creating structures and controlling armies. There's no running or jumping in League of Legends, at least in the sense Eminem favors. This is an article.
How does it say anything about, like, analytics? Does it say how many people viewed this article? Oh no!
Jesus. No, I doubt it.
I am in
This is from July 16, 2019, written by David Schmidt.
What site is this for?
Thethings.com.
The Things. You know, I gotta say, I'm glad it exists.
I don't know that glad it
exists. Dude, I just did one half of the 3D.
Did you?
Yeah.
I'm too busy reading this.
Bubba wasn't there. I just did Devon's half.
This incredible article.
Oh, a blazing!
Blaze it!
No! Get him! I just gotta grapple the band! Please! Oh no, oh no. He's very hard, by the way. I don't know how I've lasted this long. He's backing up. He's a coward. Got him! Oh, you're going down, Cruz!
Oh,
he's not out, though.
Oh, so close.
Hang on, you know what this means. Oh no, I thought I was grappling him. I didn't realize he was gonna only pick him up. Oh, I'm dead, this is it. No, wait, maybe not.
I can't find which game he's in.
Well, look up 50 Cent's first game, because it's not Blood on the Sand, which is its own wonderful thing.
Let's end this now. Bulletproof.
Got him! 50 Cent Bulletproof, you're right. I never played that. And I think we should play it one day. Not right away. We need to space these things out. I found
that one. You're saying that we can't have too much hip hop back to back?
We can't. I don't know if I can handle the pressure of becoming.
Are you saying that we don't deserve this?
No, I'm saying I can't handle the pressure right now of becoming an urban icon.
Oh.
Don't act like you have the time to be an urban icon.
No, not at all. I work a full-time job.
It's a lot of work. You got to put all of yourself into that story. Looking dang
things in here tonight. Yeah, beyond you, partner.
You the man. So who you going to take home, huh?
Wait, I get to choose a woman? I get to choose as if I get to choose a girlfriend.
Oh my god. How about the cross-eyed gal? Kimora.
Kimora?
Look at her eyes.
I don't know. It looks more like a lazy eye. That's all. Because her right eye, the one we're seeing on our left, is just sort of looking down at something. Her left eye is looking off at something to the side.
So I don't understand anything going on.
I don't know.
I've got my picks.
I like how much Cindy J looks like kind of Evangeline Lilly.
Kind of, yeah, I'm liking that.
And I'm a fan. Lil' Kim is one of them. Are all of these real people, or?
Maybe?
Hold I on, would probably.
Cindy.
I don't know.
J. Oh, yeah. Cindy J's a real person.
All right.
Wait, Cindy J, the Def Jam Wrestling. Cindy Johnson.
Cindy Johnson, okay, all right.
I don't know if she's a real person or if just a character made for the game.
Oh. It's kind of weird that there would just be Lil Kim and then three, I don't know.
Yeah.
You know what? We're going with Kimora.
Here we go.
She sounds interesting or looks interesting.
Oh, no, she's a real person. She's a model, actress. First video game role was in Need for Speed Underground, where she played Samantha. She's the girl on the scene who knows all the people, the tricks, the cool hangouts. Oh. Cindy Johnson is a very capable fighter. Fast and aggressive with a tight set of moves and a great reach.
You know what? It just occurred to me. Shauna looks the friendliest.
So my picks.
Okay, go for it.
I like Cindy J because she looks like she'd be really mean to me.
Okay.
But I also like Shauna because she looks like a sweetheart.
Yeah, I'm gonna go with the sweetheart.
I like them both for you know the opposite reason.
Right. Here we go.
She's with me.
Oh.
Why am I not convinced? I said, back off.
Time to fight for the love of Shauna. Load up. Come on. I gotta fight this man. I have to take his woman. As if she were property. Oh, no.
That Cindy J is a looker.
Yeah.
I mean, she looks like she might be like half Japanese.
She had that kind of look. I think you might be right.
Yeah.
Oh, hey. Look at that.
Wait, why are you fighting DDT? 9 again?
Oh, is this 9? Oh, well, because did you miss what happened?
I did. I was reading about my new girlfriend, Cindy J.
So I went to talk to Shauna, and he stepped in front of me like, hey, you back off. That's my girl.
What did you do?
He started fighting me.
You didn't try to reason with him, but hey, listen.
There was no time. And he just beat the crap out of me the entire time that I had my blazing going.
So what you're saying is this guy is a real jerk.
Yeah. The real jerk. The best use of that, I think, was when he, for Norm MacDonald and his real jerk joke was probably the cannibal story. Just everybody look up Norm MacDonald cannibal
Canadian
story.
Canadian cannibal.
Yeah. It's incredible.
I mean, this guy was a real jerk.
What I'm saying is the guy's a real jerk.
You ever listen to, or you ever hear his 9/11 was a national tragedy jokes?
Yes. Yes.
Those are the best.
Those are funny.
When he did it to Andy Dick was the best, where he just turns, well, 9/11 was a national tragedy.
Yeah. It's
and you just see Andy Dick fall apart inside.
By the way, I just stole his woman by beating the shit out of him.
You didn't steal his woman. You took your woman.
Goodness. That's I got a new voicemail.
DJ Spooks.
I was hoping 9 left me a voicemail.
It was that. That was his voicemail. Oh. It just goes, DJ Spitz.
That's the boss, by the way. The one that likes us. Hey, yo, kid, remember, you take a cut of all the action that goes on behind the scenes of your fights. There's always bets going on, so the more cool shit you pull off in the heat of battle, the bigger your cut will be. Oh.
Hey, this is Rollins. If you're not there right now, you better be on the way down to the gym.
I don't want to upset Henry Rollins.
Hey, yo, it's Blaze, man. Oh, how'd it go with that honey last night? Hit me back.
How did it go? I never got to find out. Is she in my crib? She's not.
Maybe she had errands to run.
All right. So you had a suggestion that we make this a game we come back to every once in a while.
I said that?
Yeah. You were like, what if we... I love for people who watch this one day after the next, like every day. Who don't realize, like, when we have a lot of time between recordings, yeah. They hear something one day, and the next day you're going, what?
Yeah. I just sound like a fucking crazy person in every one of these.
So let's leave the story here, because it seems like some more stuff's about to happen.
Okay.
And throughout.
And we'll come back to this like a week or two, maybe.
Yeah, whatever. You know what? Maybe we just stretch this game out throughout the year.
We can do that. For some reason, we're putting like emphasis on this game specifically to be the one we do throughout the year.
Def Jam Fight for New York is the game of 2021.
It's February 13th, and you know what that means, folks. Another episode of Def Jam.
Does it have
Fight
to be?
For New York.
You know what? I mean, I'll do it. That's my birthday.
Oh, yeah.
I was like, February 13th, are we going to play this game for my birthday?
Not only are we doing it once a month on the 13th of every month, but we're starting it. We're making it a point to make it a birthday party for you.
I'm fine with that.
Oh, my God. Should we actually Zoom each other, like get video of us dressed in hip-hop attire for a birthday party, a Zoom birthday party for you?
Maybe. I'm sure people watching are going to want to. See that. If we forget, somebody's got to remind us.
If you want us to dress like a couple of street toughs who are up to no good, while playing Def Jam Fight for New York for Russ's birthday party, I guess let us know in the comments.
I'm just, I guess it's too late to do it for yours.
I actually tried to remove my birthday from Facebook. And I guess I didn't hit save. So I was like, all right, no birthday messages coming in. I'm in the clear. And then I hear like, broop, broop, broop. And I'm like, wait, no. And then I just got flooded with all these like, happy birthday. And I had an anxiety attack because I'm like, I can't answer all of them.
I have to do that myself. I gotta turn that shit off because I hate that. I honestly didn't care back when I used Facebook, but it's been years. And every year on my birthday, I'm like, oh, all these people. I have to be that. I have to hit like or thank.
I just
people.
Don't like. I don't like any emphasis on my birthday.
That's
I
fair.
Haven't done anything for my birthday in what fucking 15 years.
That's
When's
fair.
The last time anybody paid attention to my birthday?
At least 16 years ago.
Yeah,
because that was your 21st birthday.
I tell people that and they don't like. They're like, oh no way, and I'm like, no, for real. I haven't celebrated my birthday in probably about 15, 16 years. And no, they people seem to take issue with that.
Because who cares?
That's how I feel. I don't like people putting like any extra thought into me that they already have to.
Yeah, same here. Same here. So.
So if you said happy birthday to me, thank you guys, but I don't care.
This has been great, by the way, with this music in the background.
Yeah,
makes it sound like you're really saying some serious stuff. All right, everybody.
I just kind of wish this music played just like during my life.
Yeah, just followed you around at work.
The song is about me.
People hear it slowly fading in as you. Oh, Chad's close.
Is this Busta?
I don't know who it is. It said earlier,
like
I think, but I didn't catch it. But all right,
that has to be Busta.
Could be. But guys, it's the end of the year. Have a good night. We'll see you tomorrow for a brand new year with a brand new game.
Whoa! What is it gonna be?
Oh, we're starting the year off right. And if you want to know what it means to start the year off right, you have to tune back in tomorrow to see what that means.
Oh, that's right. You already picked a game, and I don't know what it is.
I picked a game, and for a good reason, but you'll see why tomorrow.
Oh, I can't wait.
Goodbye, everyone.
Goodbye.